morning. How's everyone this morning? I feel great, feel good, and what an opportunity here to the cloud. There's a cloud cover so I can tape. All the shadows are not in the way. And hopefully I'm ironing out everything. What you just saw was a trampoline, jump on the trampoline, jump off a trampoline. Let's do it again. So I just did this yesterday for the first time. Every day I'm doing a lot of things for the first time. This is very stressful because you don't quite know what to expect. Doing a lot of trampoline work. I'll show you what we're doing here. One-legged trampoline work. Probably the toughest exercise that I've ever done is jumping on one leg on this trampoline. So I'm getting into hopping on one leg also, like this. So welcome to the video. What I'm doing is I'm working out very intensely as per the instructions of the Holy Spirit. Why? Why question it? This is what the advice is. So I'm doing it and it's yielding benefits that I don't know exactly what they are. I was in a restaurant a couple days ago and I was walking around and it felt like I was floating around. I said, what is this? Very amazing feeling. So working on the core, really hammering the core, okay? This is really important. Let's take a look at this. Stable. Let's do some core work here. You sit on the ball like this, and then you start. Move your legs side to side, your arms the opposite, like this. And then roll on the ball, too. Side to side on the ball. Tremendous. Tremendous workout for the. What the heck was that? That's some kind of insect. What the heck is that? Wow. I don't know. That's not a tick or something? I think it might be a tick. Let's move the tick along somewhere else. Yeah, if it doesn't fly, see. How do I move that tick along? How do I move the tick along here? I just gotta something here. That's up. Where'd it go? I lost sight of it. Shoot. There it is. There it is. Come on, insect. Okay, got the insect here. Move it out. Amazing. Jump it on the board like this, and then go to the opposite side, jump it back. Okay. You can see there's action happening, right? Stuff is happening. Another exercise here. Bounce up and down, keeping your balance. Tremendous core exercise. All right, let me show you something. Another key part of my exercise program. This is PVC. Scoot this out of the way. All right, here we go. It's full of sand. This is just a great toning strength exercise. Just gets everything. Another great exercise, but you can't see it. It's like this. Go like this, and then swing like this. So this one, we turn this front like this, and then from here, pull it through really strongly. Real fast. Same way. Tremendous torque exercise. So, are skateboards for? Sitting on. Of course. That's what we do. We sit on the skateboards. Skating is called mental, going mental. This is our problem. We think that mentality has a beginning and an ending. It doesn't. Vision of intrinsic spaciousness is right now. Everything is always in the now. There's no beginning and there's no ending to anything whatsoever. It's when we try to assess a beginning, we're searching for a beginning to mentality. The belief in mentality is the beginning and the ending. Beginning and ending are one, actually. So when we go skating, do all these tricks, that's going mental. We want to do all these mental tricks. We're all in this mental mode. We want to get out into abidance mode instead of mental mode. Okay, very simple. It's just a shift of attention, actually. You just stop searching for a beginning. You stop your attention. Says, we're looking for, where's the beginning so we can determine the ending? Okay, there's no beginning and no ending. There's just the moment. Just the moment. So, for skateboard, we could do a little skating around, but then we come to rest and say, oh yeah, okay, that's just mental. Let's just sit on the board. It's very comfortable, I love it. That's the ultimate trick, is just sitting on the board. Be in shape? I don't know. But Holy Spirit knows. There's a reason for it. Could be anything at all. But maybe it's a little bit of this and that. It gives you a little edge in terms of, they say, well, you're just not being mental because you can't. You're not skating because you can't. You're not doing this stuff because you can't. If you could, you would. And I say, no, I'm in great shape. I could. But I'm not. It's different, right? There is no mental. It's all light is clear light, actually. It's all clear light. The light and the darkness is just mental illusion. There are no obscuring clouds. There aren't any. So it's not how do you get rid of them. It's your attention recognizes it. There's never been any. So we go from all the danger of a skateboard to sitting on it, where suddenly we feel completely safe and secure. Just like that. Simple shift of purpose, right? So we're not denigrating illusion, we're just saying it doesn't exist. Okay. It never has. There's only been the clear light, actually. It was just a game with our attention that we were playing. I just sit like this. Just wow it. Now, do another exercise. Out with the skateboard. Again, core exercise. Tire. Bend over like this. Keep the tire outside your knees like this, and you stop it. You prevent it from going any further. You back and forth, and you're preventing it. You can even do it oscillate inside your knees. Oh, just even more difficult. Wow, that gets the RPM up. Now we can do tire sitting too, like this, or just a tire sitter. One more tire exercise. I'm getting tired, for sure. Larger swing. You get the idea. Tire City. Great, Tire City. Okay. Here's our old standby jumping rope. That's the only trick I do a skateboard. Flip it over so I can sit on it. Okay, sit quietly. Just So cardio is way up now. So you just let it settle down. When your cardio is way up, it's like a wow. What do? Can you slow it down like by holding your breath? No. You just let it naturally settle down. So it's very similar. When you see directly, clear light, the wow arises. You say, wow, that's just all mentation. I don't have to put my attention there. It gets your spiritual cardio up, okay? Like, whoa, 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 wow. Just sit and let it calm down naturally. Just like letting our cardio calm down here. It's a great analogy. It just naturally, gradually slows down, doesn't it? Same thing with the wow. Now, once it calms down, you can decide, do I want to do some more, or is this enough? Just like a workout. At some point, you say, you know what? That's enough. I had this great smoothie this morning. It was a banana, a carrot, 2 pieces of kale, chocolate protein drink. It was fabulous. I'm gonna do that one again. Put in a banana, put some kale in, put a carrot, and chocolate protein drink. It's perfect. It was absolutely perfect. Now, when the world descends into goes mental, which it's going mental right now, you can feel it, right? It's very good to have these disciplines that you can rely upon. Your spiritual, your wow practice, full stop in the wow practice, your nutrition, and your physical fitness. Those three pillars. It's very important to have these habits in place. And you just stay with the habits. That's all. You say, I'll be okay. I trust in my habits. You want to see my golf swing? Of course. Okay. Let's do it. Okay, very unorthodox now. Knees bent, waist bent, arms fully extended. Golf club out as far as possible. Look at that. Normally, it's like this. Okay? So I'm at about twice as far. Heel of the club down. Toe up. Instead of like this, toes up like this. Hands really low. Look how low the hands are. Look how they're down by my knees. Instead of hands being up by the waist like this, this is a normal swing, like this. I'm going like this, completely unorthodox, right? And then you bring it back like this. Real, real low, and then come through with your arms fully extended, like that. Look at that hitting position. Perfect, right? Look at that. The balance, the power. So. There's the finish shoe. Perfect. So that's the new golf swing. It's fabulous, but nowhere on the internet, nowhere will you see that swing anywhere. Nobody has that swing. That swing was given to me by Longchenpa. And I have perfect balance through it, power and balance through it. It's ideal, but very unorthodox, very unmental. It's beyond mentalness, okay? The mental will never do that. So how do you get that swing? You got to trust in clear light, direct clear light vision. There's no beginning and ending to mental, okay? You have to trust it. Very few will do that yet. So the world's going mental right now. You can feel it, right? It's a crisis. It's an all-out crisis, actually, right now. So you don't want to battle mentally with anything. Just drink your smoothies, do your workout, do your full stop in the wow, laugh, and just, we will have guidance for you. Okay, so are we finished? Not yet. I feel a little more push here. So,
the board.
If I can do the board flip. Yeah, what do we do? More jump rope, of course. More jump rope. We'll just stop with 50 there. Don't want to wind it up too much. You don't want to overdo it. So we mustn't allow ourselves to engage with the mental. You can feel it. If something's gone mental, you can feel it, right? So we have these other things we can do. And we keep our attention on full stop in the wow, preparing for the breakthrough. I had a big breakthrough this morning. Okay, so what I do, just stay in stride, made my smoothie, doing my exercise, work, this and that. You just stay that way, stay smooth, stay in your habits. Don't go mental. Don't engage with anything that's gone mental at this point. Just say, maybe later I'll engage with it, not right now. So in a crisis, you don't engage with what's gone mental. You let it go. I was driving yesterday and I saw this animal moving around. I said, what the heck's going on? It was a raccoon. I said, oh, I better slow down. And then I saw that there was another raccoon on its back on the side of the road. It got hit by a car and it was all spazzing out, spastically on its back, you know, in its death throes. And the other raccoon was frantically going around trying, what can I do? What can I do? What can I do? What can I do? Well, the spazzing out is going mental. It was a sign to me, this is what's going to happen with the world. It's going to go mental. And so this other raccoon was all freaked out. So I don't know what to do. Just stay in your habits. Okay, those who go mental, they're trying to change reality. Okay, this is their little game they're playing. Let them play their game. It's okay. coming and going, beginning and ending, coming and going, beginning and ending. There's no coming and going. There's no beginning and ending, actually. This is direct, clear light vision. So I was wondering, what should I tell this raccoon? I should have said, just go make a smoothie. Yeah. Raccoon smoothie. Let your friend go mental. They're fine. They haven't begun. They haven't ended. There's no beginning, ending. It's still clear light. Let them go mental. You stay with your habits. Spiritual practice. Three pillars. Spiritual practice, nutrition, fitness. Those three. Just keep them going. Just wait. Be patient. There's nothing to fix, actually. There's nothing to fix. Going mental means there's something to fix. Everything's perfect. Everything's absolutely perfect. The moment is still the moment. There's only the moment. There's nothing else. So let your attention rest on the moment. Not a moment of time, not a mental moment, but momentness, momentness. Okay. Very great. So many synchronicities taking place now. It's just amazing, isn't it? That's what it's meant to be that way. Meant to be that way. So just let it continue to happen and trust it. Just trust it. Stay with your good habits. Good habits get you through. Good habits get you through. Struggle mentally to get to the breakthrough. It's there. It's already there. It's already there. Your attention, just a simple, gentle shift of attention. That's it. So easy. It's only mentality that makes it seem difficult. But remember, it's not difficult. It's impossible. Mentality, there's no such thing, actually. It can't do anything. There's no coming and there's no going. There's no arriving. There's no leaving. So, our delusion is that it's difficult. No, it's impossible to change reality. It's not difficult, it's impossible. So it's never happened. We don't need to fix it. We don't need to stop something. Okay, just shift our attention to recognize it never happened. There's nothing that ever happened. So I trust in this, I trust in the gurus, I trust in our training, our practice, and this will bear fruit for us as the world goes incredibly mental, right? The worst going mental, the worst ever, by far, by far. It doesn't matter. We're okay, we're okay, we're okay. All right. It's okay to have a skateboard, but just sit on it, you know, for the most part. You can have a little fun with it too, but it's great for sitting on it.